assigned and designated for recreation, play, and rejoicing. 2 days of happiness. The Holy Prophet, alayhi salatu wasalam, upon his arrival and observing these 2 days, questioned the people of Medina, what is the significance of these 2 days? And the people replied that these are 2 days that we observe from the time of Jahiliyyah. And they are 2 days of recreation and happiness. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us in place of these 2 days 2 better days. One of them is the Eid, Eid al-Fitr, which is celebrated at the end of Ramadan. And the second of the 2 Eids is the Eid al-Adha, which is the celebration of the day. And both of these Eids, they are significant in the fact that they are not just celebrations. It is not just a day of happiness, a day of wearing new clothes, but connected with both of these days is a very important spiritual connection, i.e. at the end of the month of Ramadan, it signifies the end of the month of fasting. And this Eid also has a spiritual connection, which is traced and linked to Sayyidina Ibrahim and Sayyidina Ismail alayhi salam. About whom the Holy Quran talks about. It is mentioned in Surah Al-Safat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam, that when he said, after being tortured and persecuted by his people, that inni zahibun ila rabbi sayyadin, that I am migrating to where my Lord will guide me. So then he made a dua, Rabbi habli min salihin, that, oh my Lord, grant me a child from the pious. And this child was given to Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam at the age of 86 years old. Prior to this, he had no children. And Hazrat Ismail alayhi salam was the first child that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave to Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam. فَبَشَّرْنَاهُ بِالْغُلَامِ الْحَلِيمِ. We gave him Ibrahim, like tidings of a ghulam, a boy who is very forbearing. فَلَمَّا بَلَغَ مَعْهُ السَّعْيَ. This young child, given to Sayyidina Ibrahim at the age of 8, when he grows and approaches the age where he is now able to walk around with his father and to be a great help to his father, he's able to carry out duties, to do things. قَالَ يَا بُنَيَّ إِنِّي أَرَىٰكَ الْمَنَامَ. Ibrahim alayhi salam relates to his son Ismail, oh my beloved son, إِنِّي أَرَىٰكَ الْمَنَامَ, I see in my dream the word used here is Allah, which indicates that I am constantly seeing. Because as we know, this dream appeared to Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam first on the 8th of the Hijra, when he saw in his dream someone saying to him that you are commanded to sacrifice your son. And Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam was rather unsure that is this inspiration and wahi from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or is this something which shaitan is trying to deceive you? This is why that day is called Yawm al-Tarjiyah, the day of doubt. The following day, Ibrahim alayhi salam sees the dream again. And now he recognizes that this is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is why that day is called Yawm al-Arafah, the day of recognition. And on the next day, the 10th of the Hijjah, he sees the same vision again, that he has been instructed to sacrifice Sayyidina Ismail alayhi salam. That is called Yawm al-Nahr, because on that day he had vowed and he had agreed and decided that now I am certain that this is from Allah. Hence, that is called Yawm al-Arafah. He said, "Inni arafi manami inni al-bahuka," that I am slaughtering. "Fanzur ma'ala." What do you have to say about this? He's speaking to his young child, Ismail. It doesn't mean that Sayyidina Ismail had any doubts or suspicion in what he had seen in his dream. It doesn't mean that he wasn't unsure or he didn't know what to do. What he was trying to do is trying to involve Sayyidina Ismail alayhi salam in this, by telling him that this is a vision that I have seen from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that Sayyidina Ismail alayhi salam can also happily accept this wahi and revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and also gain a great deal of sawab and reward by willingly accepting the wahi inspiration. فَانْظُرْ مَا ذَكَرْ. He said, قَالَ يَا أَبَتِ فَأَلِ مَا ذَكَرْ. Oh my father, do whatever you are being instructed to do. سَتَجِدُنِي إِنْشَاءُ اللَّهُ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. With the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will find me from amongst those who are الصَّابِرُونَ, who are patient and are willing to accept the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So all of these things are very significant on this day of Eid, how Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam, after 86 years, was given one child, a son, praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant him this. And when he is finally given this, after a few years, he will be ordered an instruction to slaughter him, sacrifice him, offer him the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Ismail alayhi salam is also willing to accept the hukum and the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and says, "Sajidni insha'Allah min as-salim." Falamma aslama, when they both submitted to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, both father and son submitted to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and were ready. This is what Islam is all about, that we accept the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in our lives, that everything what happens with the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we can hold firm to this aqeedah, this belief, that nothing will happen to us without the permission and gift of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Very important and fundamental belief as Muslims, and a belief that many people are now relinquishing, that they think whatever is happening to them is some sort of conspiracy against them, or people are determining what is happening to their future. This is absolutely incorrect as the Islamic belief. As Muslims, we believe whatever happens, happens to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it is important to place your dependence and your tawakkul on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and worship Him alone in times of happiness and in times of adversity. Worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the overwhelming lesson and moral that we learn from the story of Sayyidina Ibrahim and Sayyidina Ismail alayhi salam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, give us the tawfiq to implement these important